Mr. President, I know we'll soon be voting on these trade agreements, but I have an issue that I think has immediacy in nature and needs to be brought up now, something I've been pursuing for some time. Mr. President, we have heard FBI evidence of an alleged plot by Iran and its elite Quds force to assassinate a foreign diplomat on U.S. soil, an extraordinary act of international terrorism that demands, at a minimum, immediate enactment of the most robust sanctions against Iran possible. Were it not for the vigilance of the American intelligence community, the FBI, and all of our law enforcement and intelligence agencies working together, this plot could have not only taken the life of Saudi Arabia's ambassador to the United States, but potentially hundreds of innocent Americans here in Washington. Think of the Machiavellianism of taking out the Saudi ambassador at a downtown Washington restaurant and what that would mean in terms of lives lost and the inevitable response it would provoke from the Saudis and from the United States. In the coming weeks, we will hear the exact details of this incredible plot and the extent of the involvement of members of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard. We know the Revolutionary Guard in Iran is at the highest levels of the Iranian government. That is why I specifically targeted the Revolutionary Guard in the Iran sanctions law that is now law. The new legislation I call on my colleagues to support, that now has 76 bipartisan co-sponsors, will consolidate our original sanctions law. Mr. President, Iran's actions demand that we move this legislation in the Congress as we simultaneously go to the United Nations, to the international community, and bring to bear whatever pressure we can to convince the Chinese and the Russians to agree to tighter sanctions against Iran. The fact is, clearly, we must do all that we can to end Iran's exportation of terrorism, which has already taken lives around the globe, from Lebanon to Argentina, is responsible for attacks on coalition forces and our own soldiers in Iraq, and now threatens innocent Americans in our nation's capital. I, for one, am not shocked at the revelations we have heard in the last 24 hours. I have known what this regime is capable of, what it intends, and what it will do to achieve its goals. The time has come for this Congress to take the first step in responding to this egregious plot to conduct an assassination in a downtown Washington restaurant. Since I took federal office in 1993, then in the House of Representatives, I have raised for some time this issue of Iran and its ambitions. I have vociferously and passionately advocated on my concern on behalf of the Jewish people and the State of Israel to protect it from the threat of a radical Iranian regime. Now that threat has been directed here towards American soil, where even American citizens could have died in a plot that defies the imagination in its brashness, boldness, and irrationality. So, Mr. President, what specifically do we do? Our first act must be to immediately respond with tougher sanctions that isolate Iran politically and economically, sanctions that will freeze the assets of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps members and allies and shut down the IRGC's sources of revenue, expedite the imposition of sanctions, force companies to decide whether they want to do business with the United States or Iran, and ensure that the United States is an Iranian oil-free zone by banning imports of refined petroleum made with Iranian crude. To that end, along with Senators Lieberman and Kyle, Gillibrand, Casey Kirk, and Collins, we've introduced in the Senate the Iran, North Korea, and Syria Sanctions Consolidation Act of 2011. It's a bill that recognizes that if Iran's principal goal is to acquire weapons of mass destruction and apparently conduct brazen attacks on American soil against international officials, then it must be the policy of the United States to prevent the Islamic Republic of Iran from acquiring the capability to threaten its neighbors and to threaten nations around the world. The time has come to take that first step and move this legislation. This legislation closes the remaining loopholes in our sanctions policy. In essence, it is perfecting the sanctions policy on the CISADA that we helped pass here in the Senate. It insists on a comprehensive diplomatic initiative within the United Nations to qualitatively expand the UN Security Council sanctions regime against Iran so that Iran cannot find a financial safe harbor or a willing partner anywhere in the world. It imposes immigration restrictions on senior officials from Iran, North Korea, and Syria, and their associates who seek to enter our country. And it complements those sanctions by reaching out to the Iranian people, facilitating democracy assistance, and developing a comprehensive strategy to promote internet freedom and access to information inside of Iran. These sanctions will help deter the threat Iran poses to U.S. national security because of its suspected nuclear weapons program, and will have an impact on Iran's ability through the Revolutionary Guard and its intelligence arm to carry out another plot like the one we have uncovered. What have we learned in the last 24 hours? We have learned that the Iranian regime is a growing threat not only to its neighbors, not only to the region, but to the world, and potentially to our own homeland. We've learned that it is in the interest of the world to apply maximum pressure to the Iranian regime. We have learned that we must tighten the screws on the Iranian regime to genuinely advance the cause of stability and peace in the Middle East and clearly around the world. These sanctions are an essential means to that end. We need the ban on trade with Iran to be strong, significant, and as humanly possible, airtight. A ban that does not have Americans subsidizing the very regime that seeks to harm us by purchasing gasoline and diesel that are made of Iranian crude. Iran's actions have made it a rogue nation that must be dealt with in the strongest terms. We cannot wait for another plot like this to be uncovered. We cannot take the chance that the next one will not be uncovered. Passing the new sanctions I have proposed with, as I said, 76 of our colleagues here is a start, and we cannot, as a nation, falter. The time to act is now. Now, I applaud the White House for its quick action this week in imposing new sanctions against the people responsible for the planned attack on the Saudi ambassador and other targets in Washington. I appreciate the administration's effort to implement and multilateralize sanctions on Iran. This administration has done more to isolate Iran than any prior administration, Republican or Democratic, including their quick response this week designating individuals involved in the plot, as well as today's sanction of Iran's Mahan Air. The news this week, however, has confirmed our worst fears, that Iran will not hesitate to advance its interests regardless of the political costs. Iran, given its history of exporting terrorism against coalition forces in Iraq, in places like Argentina and Lebanon, in its continued drive to advance its nuclear weapons program, despite being slowed by U.S. and international sanctions, clearly, with the alleged plot uncovered this week, remains undeterred. It is time to take the next steps to isolate Iran politically and financially. Mr. President, we must enact sanctions now to exert the unyielding pressure of the United States government against the Iranian regime and to bring to bear the condemnation of the international community so that the regime fully understands that the world will not tolerate such actions if carried out. These sanctions will prevent us from having to face that situation in the future. They are in our national security interests. They are in the interests of Iran's neighbors, in the interest of the region, and they are in the interest of the security of every nation that wishes to secure in its borders its safe from the terrorist acts of a rogue state. That is what is at stake. That is why I look forward to a hearing that we will be having tomorrow in the Banking Committee on the effect of the sanctions legislation we already have. I believe that hearing will deduce testimony that clearly shows that because of the sanctions legislation that we already passed in the Congress, signed by the President, that in fact we have made a significant dent in Iran's commercial activities, but it has not ceased or desisted from its march to nuclear weaponry. And obviously, by this latest plot, it has not ceased or desisted from its willingness, even on U.S. soil, to carry out such an assassination. Therefore, Mr. President, the time to act is now. With that, Mr. President, yield the floor and observe the absence of quorum.